From Newtonian physics to relativity to quantum physics, all of the most useful and important theories of physics are based on this one principle. And yet, I don't think we talk about it enough. So let's do that in this video. Hello there, my name's Barth, and in this video we'll be looking at what's commonly known as the principle of least action. It forms the cornerstone of pretty much all of our major physics theories. We'll look at what this principle is and when it breaks down as well. If you enjoyed this video, then please hit the thumbs up button and subscribe for more fun physics content. Let's get into it. When we learn high school physics, we often start by studying objects that exert forces on each other. A ball hitting a wall. Two skaters pushing each other away, a planet orbiting a star. All of these systems can be studied by understanding the forces within them, and those can then help us understand how those objects will accelerate and therefore move through space. But there is another way to find what we call the equations of motion of objects in a system. We can do this by considering energy rather than forces. Let's think about a really simple system, a particle moving through space. This particle has some amount of kinetic energy due to its motion, and it has potential energy if it interacts with stuff around it, whether that be gravitational potential energy or electric potential energy or any other kind. Now, let's take notice of the point that the particle's kinetic energy depends on its speed, as kinetic energy does, and potential energy depends on its position. This will become important later. Next, we're going to calculate a quantity called the system's Lagrangian, named after Joseph-Louis Lagrange. For a simple system like this, it's just the kinetic energy minus the potential energy. Yep, minus. This Lagrangian is a surprisingly useful quantity. I've made a whole video about Lagrangian mechanics that's very related to what we're talking about in this video, so check it out up here if you're interested. I'll also leave a link in the description. But here, the Lagrangian just serves the purpose of defining another quantity known as the action. The action is defined as this particular integral here. It's essentially measuring how the Lagrangian changes over time, dt, between the time when we start studying the system, t1, and finish studying the system, t2. The equation looks complicated, but the action is just a scalar quantity, meaning it's just a single number once we've calculated the integral. We can see that the value of s changes if we change the Lagrangian for our system. And the Lagrangian changes if our system has different kinetic and or potential energies. And these energies depend on, in this case, the particle speed and position. Therefore, different values of s represent different trajectories that the particle can take through space between the times t1 and t2. The trajectory that our particle actually ends up taking is the one for which the value of s is the smallest it possibly can be, or minimal. This is known as the principle of least action. Now, technically, in some cases, it's not the least action that gives the right trajectory, but it's when s is stationary. But for our purposes, let's just say we're going with the principle of least action, or the value of s is as small as it possibly can be. So that is how we can find the trajectory of our particle from its energy, rather than by considering forces like we did with Newtonian mechanics. Now, here's the thing. How do we go about actually doing this, like mathematically? It's not like we want to try plugging in different values of kinetic and potential energy to find the ones for which the value of s is minimum. We can instead use some smart maths that essentially says, if we knew the right trajectory and we changed it a little bit, then the value of s would not noticeably change because at this point is minimal, meaning changing the path just results in a slight change of value of s. This is like if we have some function y that depends on x, and it has a minimum value, and then if we changed x slightly, the value of y would still be very close to the minimum. It wouldn't change a huge amount. Whereas if we were elsewhere, changing x would result in a noticeable change in y. Same idea here, except this is kind of like the value of s, and this is representing the trajectory. So let's talk about where the principle of least action or stationary action is used, and where the principle breaks down. With slight changes in definitions of s, and with different Lagrangians, depending on what theory we're talking about, this principle forms a core pillar of theories such as classical mechanics, thermodynamics, quantum mechanics, fluid dynamics, relativity, particle physics, and string theory. And that list gets a lot longer, I just didn't want to say things that sounded like dynamics and mechanics over and over again. However, action principles generally stop working in systems where we have dissipative forces, such as friction, that take energy out of the system. Now, you might be thinking, well, friction is a huge part of physics, and Newton's force method deals with it really well. So this is a big thorn in the side of the action principle, and you would be correct. Luckily, however, if dissipative forces are taking energy out of the system, that energy is being transferred to another system. For example, friction slowing down a rolling object results in that energy being transferred as heat to the universe around it. So if we expand our idea of what the system is to include this change, and we look at friction on a small scale and realize that it's just caused by electromagnetic interactions between particles, then technically the action principle works again. It's hard to do mathematically because you have to study all of the particle interactions and account for everything going on here, but in theory, it's doable. Thank goodness. So we've looked at the principle of least action or stationary action, which forms the cornerstone of multiple extremely important physics theories. If you enjoyed this video, then please hit the thumbs up button, subscribe, and hit the bell button for more fun physics content. A huge thanks to my Giga patrons and everyone else over on my Patreon page. I'll leave a link to that in the description if you'd like to support me on there. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you very soon.